So now what we're going to talk about is what you do once you've got all your stuff in the cloud. Once you've got all your stuff in the cloud, you can make use of new cloud-native development tools and tricks and new features in the Azure portal that can make your development life a lot easier and probably more rapid and maybe even more interesting and fun. So the first thing we'll do is we're going to take a look at the app we're going to build today. Now this app, just like the other ones that you've seen, is already available in GitHub. If you take a look here, you'll see the Smart Hotel 360 Sentiment Analysis app. We've already got a nice long README right here in the repository that walks through the process of creating every single resource that you need in Azure and configuring everything. So I won't spend a lot of time today doing that, but I encourage you to clone the repo and try it out for yourself. What I will do is I'll show you the application in its done state. Now I've got it running right here on my computer. This is a Node.js application. You can see that we've got a map right here on the homepage. We're using the Bing Maps API resource type in Azure for that. You can see that I've actually got a couple of points plotted on this map. Those are hotels that we happen to have in New York City. So I'll go ahead and click on the first one. You'll see the gold hotel. Then down here at the bottom, you'll see some positive and negative sentiments as to how that hotel is doing. We're gathering information from Twitter, which we'll talk about later on when we get into logic apps. And then we're taking the tweet data and we're sending that over to Cognitive Services Text Analysis API to figure out whether or not the tweets are positive or negative. If I look at the second one here, the Diamond Hotel, you'll see that it's even better than the first hotel, the Gold Hotel, mostly positive sentiment. We've got a red dot right here we could take a look at. If I click on that, you'll see that's the Platinum Hotel. And their sentiment isn't exactly what we refer to as platinum yet. So we can get there. We can figure out what's wrong. The nice thing is we can collect all that data, put it into a Cosmos DB, and we can figure out what we can do to make our customers happier. So if I scroll down here, you'll see that I have a couple of different resources created in a single Azure resource group. I've got an Azure Cosmos DB with a graph-backed API, or Gremlin, and I've also got a Cosmos DB with a SQL API backend, as well as that Bing Maps API resource that gives us that nice map on the homepage. I've also got, as I talked about, the Cognitive Services Text Analysis API sitting right here. And then I've got a container registry, which we'll get to right about now. So this web application that you see running in my browser is actually sitting right here in VS Code. And what I've done is written a very small Node.js application. And if I were to take a peek here at this Docker file, took a look at the Docker files in the last set of demos, you'll see that my base image is actually the Node Alpine image. So you can see that this is indeed a Node app, and what we're doing is we're packaging that Node application up. And from the last demo, you can probably guess what comes next. Once we package it up, we actually ship that out to our Azure Container Registry, where you can see that I've already got the web app running. So what I'll do is I'll right-click on this repository right here. I'm sorry for the small icon, but this right here says Deploy Image to Azure App Service. Now, I've already done that process, and what that gives me is the ability to create not only a Linux app hosting plan right here in the cloud, but I've also got a new app service, and that app service sits on top of a Linux app service plan and on top of a container, which has my Node.js code running inside of it. I've gone ahead and opened this up in the portal. I'll just click Browse. What you'll see is there's the same application already running up in Azure. Publish that out to app service directly from my ACR instance. I go back into my resource group. You'll also see that I have a logic app and a couple of other things running here. Before we get into that in too much detail, I'm going to flip over here and I'm going to show you that we have a serverless Azure function also sitting in this repository, also running right here on my computer. What I'm going to do first is I'm going to open that Azure function up and I'm going to put a breakpoint right here on line 11 on this context log call. And then I'm going to hit F5. What that's going to do is that's going to spin up this Azure function running right here on my computer. And what it's going to do is it's going to wait for incoming requests. Now, how are we actually going to send this requests is we're going to drop data directly into a Cosmos DB database. So if I were to go to the Data Explorer for this SQL-backed database and take a look at documents, you can see that I don't have any documents in the database at all yet. How are we going to get documents in there? Pretty simply, what we're going to do is use Twitter. So what I'll do now is I'll open up this logic app. And inside of this logic app, I'll show you the designer for it. You'll see that all I had to do was drag in a couple of different actions and steps. I didn't even really have to do any code. So what's going to happen here is anytime somebody posts a tweet with the string Smart Hotel 360, we're going to take that tweet and we're going to create a new document in Azure Cosmos DB that's going to contain data that we copied directly out of that tweet. If you see that I put my cursor in the document here, I can actually change different properties if I might want to add properties to what I'm collecting. We don't need anything except for the text of the tweet, and we want to get the user's username from the tweet as well, because if we see somebody isn't happy in our hotel, we make changes based on their tweet, we might want to reach back out to them and see if they're happier now. One of the other things that I really like about Logic Apps is that I don't have to run this now and then go out and post a tweet and wait for the tweet to get picked up. If I want to just retry an existing request, I can scroll down here and you can see that we've got the previous runs. I'll go ahead and click on one of these runs and you can actually see what got posted and what got created directly in the Cosmos DB. What I want to do is simply resubmit this. I want to resubmit this, and what's going to happen is it's going to take the same data, drop the same data into that Cosmos DB database, and as soon as it drops it in there, my function is going to wake up because it will be triggered. So I'll just hit submit. It's going to ask me, are you sure you want to do this? I'll click yes. It'll drop that data in the Cosmos DB. And right away, we flip right into the Azure function where you can see that I'm already debugging. And if I take a look right here, I've already captured that tweet. And if I were to just allow this to run, what will happen next is that this Azure function will actually take that tweet data, send it over to text analysis, get back the sentiment, and then drop that sentiment along with the username of the tweet and some other information into a graph-backed, Gremlin-backed Cosmos DB database, which you can see right here in the portal. And this time I'll go into the database and I'll click on the graph, and I want to apply the filter. And apologies for this being a little bit small in the portal on camera, but if you see here, I've actually got the graph of everything in this graph database, and if I were to scroll in, I could actually take a deeper look at some of the data points. I know that that last one came from me, so if I were to scroll down here and click on my Twitter handle, you'll see right here is the tweet that I posted and some of the information that I were to send through and the text and the text analysis that came out of Cognitive Services as a result of it. That's great. What you've seen me do here is actually use some of the existing technology we've already talked about, Docker to package up our application, ACR to store that container until I'm ready to publish it somewhere, like App Service in this case, or in the previous case, Azure Kubernetes Service. We've also talked about how we can use cloud native development tools like Logic Apps and serverless functions so that we can get up and running with new features and new development in no time at all. So, hope you enjoyed this, and try these things out and let us know if you have any feedback or ideas on the demos. Thanks a lot.